3 million Australians with student debt could be better off under major changes set to be introduced from next year. The federal government says it will raise the minimum repayment threshold for student loans and slash repayment rates.
Kate Jones studied communication at UTS, graduating yesterday with a big debt.
But I checked it the other day and it's literally $45,000. So for a 3 year course, I was a bit shocked.
The 20-year-old recently started as a casual multimedia video producer at Nine. And while she will have to start paying off her debt now she's working, she might not have to pay as much, with the federal government announcing it'll lift the minimum repayment threshold from incomes of $54,000 to $67,000.
What this will do is help people who are just starting out, who've just finished uni, who've just finished TAFE.
It also plans to reduce the amount those with a student debt have to repay, based on incomes of up to $180,000 a year. For example, a graduate earning $70,000 a year would see a $1,300 reduction in their minimum repayments, while a graduate earning $80,000 would pay $850 less.
What it means is that there's more money in your pocket rather than in the government's.
But the opposition claims the changes will leave students worse off in the long term.
Someone on $70,000 with an average HECS debt of $27,000 repaying $450 a year will take 58 years to repay their debt.
More announcements set to ease cost of living pressures for younger Australians are expected in the coming days, a move the Albanese government will no doubt be hoping translate into votes, with an election not too far away.
This week, a change in the way loan repayments are indexed will be debated in Parliament, which could see $3 billion of student debt wiped before Christmas.
I am glad that it's not something I have to think about straight away and it's sort of a later problem.
Kate Creedon, Nine News.